and welcome to my channel. Today I have a review, first impression sort of video for you. I'm not sure yet what I'm going to call this, but either way, it's about the Urban Decay Born to Run palette. Quite frankly, more about it later, but this is like the first palette in years by Urban Decay that I was really excited about. As usual, as expected of Urban Decay, their packaging is absolutely amazing. It's very, very beautiful. There's a lot of photos on it for like from perfect vacation destinations and such. Like London over here, and I think this is San Francisco. Other than that, I don't recognize any because I'm not very good with recognizing cities, apparently. Or, you know, there's also the sea, and yeah, the sea could be anywhere, basically. But point is, it's a very beautiful packaging. Even the box it came in was actually quite beautiful. This is one of those things. There's really no use in keeping the cardboard sleeve that was around it, but I still don't want to toss it, so this is probably going to go somewhere. Somewhere where I'll keep it, and yep. It's just pretty, it's a pretty throwaway, so I don't know what I'm gonna do with it, but I'm just not gonna toss it. But anyway, the palette itself is very beautiful. Also, it feels quite heavy and, you know, good in terms of quality. It closes with a magnet, which is also very nice, because then it won't fall open, and if you actually travel with it, spill its contents all over your suitcase. Never a good thing. So yeah, I'm glad that it actually closes as well. It also has a huge mirror, which is also very, very handy for, again, traveling. Also for at home and filming a makeup tutorial, so that's also a good thing. Feels very sturdy, very big. They really used all the space they had to make the mirror, which I'm very happy about. And then, of course, the colors itself, like, they're so beautiful. I also love how there's, like, a row of nudes and then, like, two rows. Well, mostly nudes. This one is more of a gold. This one is a peach. But the more neutral tones that you can use for an everyday look. And then the more deeper shades, darker shades, shimmery shades for the more glam and special occasions. I pretty much, whenever I do makeup, I end up with something like this. I don't do nude and natural looks, but that's beside the point. But yeah, I just love the balance in it. And also, I love the balance between mattes and shimmers. It has enough shimmers to go full on glam. I'm really trying to not shine light on you with the mirror. But anyway, I really do think like there's enough mattes in there to make a complete look, like to deepen up the crease and stuff as well. I just really love the balance. Like personally, I love using shimmers on my eyelids, but I also find it very important, I guess, to use mattes in my crease to really deepen it up. So I really love it when a palette has bold options. And yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say about the palette in advance. Let's get on to the actual testing. I've already primed my eyelids and obviously also done my eyebrows in advance. I've primed my eyelids using my usual concealer, powder, then color tattoo method. I recently actually rediscovered the color tattoos, but anyway, point is, this way I just know that any differences compared to my other eyeshadows are really going to be, you know, because of the eyeshadows in this palette and not due to the base. Yeah. Other than that, I have absolutely no idea what I'm going to do, so let's just jump into it. Okay, I think I'm going to start out with the crease shade. I'm going to start out using Still Shot specifically, which is a peach shade. Next up, I'm going to use Hellwright, which is this burgundy shade over here, which I was really excited about because that's pretty much my favorite color. You can probably tell by how my background looks about half the time, right about. But yeah, I'm going to use that on a tinier brush and then apply it deeper in the crease. In terms of quality, I gotta say, these are really, really good eyeshadows. Quite frankly, this is my third time trying out the palette. I've already, like, when I got it in the mail, I obviously couldn't wait, so I immediately tried it out without any primer or actual any other makeup on my skin. But yeah, I just really, really wanted to try it out, and so far all the colors I tested are really, really pigmented. And what's more, they actually blend out nicely as well, which is rather an important thing for an eyeshadow palette, of course. Because as you can see, like, they're very intense, but then I go over them and they just blur out beautifully. So I'm really pleased with that. Also, one thing I like is that they don't actually disappear when I blend. Like, I like to build up colors, but I don't have to build it up endlessly for it to work, which is also a big time saver. Just move back to Still Shot to blend everything even further. Then it's really quickly the eyebrow highlight. I'm just using the palest shade in the palette. Then for the lid, I'm going to use Big Sky, which is a shimmer. However, I'm going to apply it without a setting spray, just to really test it out. Because in my opinion, an eyeshadow should perform with or without setting spray. So yeah, I'm just going to grab it and hope it goes well. This is an absolutely beautiful, stunning color. Wow. By the way, this is, like, to me, really, like, in years, quite frankly, the first Urban Decay palette, and I'm actually really excited about. As in, for the last couple of years, I always felt like Urban Decay, you know, their quality is, without exception, in my opinion, always good. However, they just did a lot of nude palettes, or, like, the glitter overlay thing with the Moondust palette. And I don't know, it just didn't excite me, you know, it didn't make me want to buy it. With a nude palette, me personally, for a start, I don't do nude eye looks very often to begin with. But when I do, I always go for the same, you know, the same specific eyeshadows anyway. So, yeah, I really love this palette. Actually has a lot of weird, well, weird, you know, colors that you don't find everywhere else, like this one. So, yeah, it's really, really cool. Being as turquoise-ish and purple-ish don't really blend together all that well, naturally. I'm going to use Wild Heart, which is pretty much the same color as the crease, but then with shimmers in the outer corners, just to sort of make it go together. I'll also use it to blend the eyeshadow, like the eyelid, a little bit towards the crease. It's a difficult explanation, you can see what I'm doing. I don't know if you could hear that crow in the background just now, but does anyone else have that where when you hear a crow, you're immediately reminded of horror movies and immediately think, oh no, there's a ghost going to pop up at any moment now? I always have that. I just love horror movies, so that's probably just something weird that I immediately think about. Then for the under eye, I'm going to use the burgundy shade and blend it out with the peach shade. I'm also going to add a little bit of Big Sky near the inner corner. Then for the inner corner highlight, I'm going to use Breakaway, the absolute palest shade. I could call it a day here and just, you know, this would be a normal, like, full-on look already with some mascara, but I do want to try out Jet as well. Which looks to me like a very, very, very nice shade of black. Like, not just black black, it seems to have some sort of depth to it. It's very hard to explain, but I really like the looks of it. So, I want to try if I can do an eyeliner with it. Again, I'm not using any setting spray. I really want to show the eyeshadows on their own as they are. Also, I want to keep it quite soft and not go for a very harsh liner this time. I'm keeping this part here empty as far as the black eyeshadow goes. I prefer to just do it here and then in the inner corner. And for me, that already gives a quite a complete eyeliner look and a little bit below the eye, as you could just see me doing. Okay, the eye look is pretty much done. I'm just adding a little bit of black pencil in the right outer corners. Right in the outer corners is what I mean to say. Just to make sure that everything is still, you know, nice and visible once I add mascara. And I'm also going to use it to fill in the waterline. Random decision, leaving things alone is something I cannot do, is I'm going to use a very short stubby brush just to blend the eyeliner. Eyeshadow liner a little bit more inwards, using Jet again. using the more fluffy side of the brush to blend it out a little bit more. By the way, for a black, this really blends out extremely well. So yeah, personally on me, I'm not a fan of the classic smoky eye, but I think if you are a fan of the classic smoky eye, this would actually be a very good shade to use for that. Just applying a good layer of mascara. I don't want to add falsies, although of course there's always a possibility to do. And that brings us to the final result. I just finished it off with a little bit of powder foundation, blush, highlight and lipstick. And that's it. Kept it very simple. Really wanted to just focus on the eyes. So yeah, my final conclusion about this palette is probably already clear. I really, really like it. I gotta admit, I was on the fence for a little bit about whether or not I'd buy it or not. Because it is quite expensive. Well, for my standards at least. It's 51 euros in the Netherlands. So yeah, all in all, you know, it does cost money and all. However, you know, like, it's not a budget product, but I do think it's definitely worth its money. Like, for a start, you get a sturdy palette, that actually is very nice and compact for travel as well, with a huge mirror in it, and 3x7, correct me if I'm wrong, 21 colors. 3x7 is 21, right? I think so, I'm horrible at counting. Point is, yeah, a lot of colors with a good variety between mattes and shimmers and just types of colors. So all in all, you know, I do think that's very handy to have. Also, the colors themselves are very pigmented. They're easy to blend. The shimmers are even shimmery without adding setting spray and they just cover really, really nicely. So yeah, I definitely think this palette is worth its money. I really, really love it. And that's pretty much the end of this review. I really hope this was useful to some of you if you're still wondering on whether or not to buy this. I think, at least me personally, I think it's worth it. Other than that, by the way, if you did enjoy this video, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to, you can also subscribe to my channel. I do a lot of makeup tutorials mostly. And, you know, considering the fact that there's a lot of colors in this palette that I still really want to put on my eyelids, you're probably also, in that case, going to see some more looks with this palette. Other than that, below the video, as always, I'll put the stuff that I've used on my eyeballs today, because it's really the only interesting part of my face right now, the rest was just randomly thrown on. I'll also list all the names, the color names of the shades of this palette that I used on my eyes today. Other than that, below the video, you can always find all my social media accounts and names. I'm mostly active on Instagram and I really love it if you'd want to follow me there. I also always post it there whenever I've uploaded a new video onto my YouTube channel. Other than that, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!